again, and fingers crossed nobody leaves this time and we should be able to actually kick this game off.
I've been thoroughly impressed with Tyrion, though. He looks like he's really come back and committed to League of Legends. And we know he's a fantastic jungler. You know, he has evolved from, and not many people can do this, has evolved from that one-trick fiddle that was there two seasons ago. Not many people do that. Not many people make a successful transition from a one-trick to a multi-tool jungler and actually somehow retain their high-elo levels. You know, not many people can actually make that transition easily. So, you know, all respect to Tyrion. He's done a really good job there.
Absolutely. And I think that's a key thing, is what's in the future now for Tyrion as well. Because, you know, he's been in the scene for a very long time, and that's always been the conversation, like this X one-trick fiddle, like, can he ever get back on the horse? It seems like that is going to be the case here, especially if he's, like, pushing up toward Masters now. If he can continue to climb, then he could actually be looking like one of the best junglers in the UK if he can continue that climb. And especially if he can make it to Comic-Con, that would certainly be a step in the right direction.
Absolutely. And they actually, you know, do come in as the slight favourites here in this scenario. But with the roster changes, I think it becomes a lot closer than it would seem.
I think as well, it becomes a little bit cloudier, because we don't really know how Batmany are going to be able to perform with this new roster. Obviously, we know that these new guys are good. We know that there's potentially going to be more strategy, maybe just better mechanics. We'll have to wait and see. But you also have the negatives of a new roster in that your team isn't coordinated to the same level. You've not built up that synergy over time. And ironically, synergy. I just realized that. No pun intended. But, you know, that could actually be a serious detriment.
Absolutely. And you often find when you bring new people in who are higher rated that sometimes they try to take control because they feel that they know better. That's something that happens in every sport in a team game. So, you know, it's about finding that balance between having someone who's excellent but maybe more of an individual player, or having someone who is okay but plays well and gels well into the team. So I want to see how these guys perform on a team level basis. I think that's going to be the most important thing. Yeah. But speaking of strategies, we should talk about these overall team compositions, Munch.
Yeah, I think that is correct. I don't know why you passed that one to me. I'm just going to pass it straight back. Scavenger, talk to me about these compositions, because you're the guy that knows the stuff.
I just meant, you know, I just was doing like a rolling conversation, you know, like, oh, yeah, good idea, kid, and just let's talk about something.
pass it to the play-by-play to analyze everything.
So I guess we'll look at Sensei. I don't want to talk for too long, basically. I thought, I'll let you say some words, and then I'll bring it.
Well, talk to me about the composition coming out from
what
Sensei.
What a great idea, kid. Munchables. So Sensei have got this very heavy pick composition here. You know, if they make a pick, they've got Chain CC, they've got lots of burst, especially as Ezreal and Veigar make their way towards the later stages of the game. And then with just having that Cage and that Gnar ultimate, they have an element of a team fight. You know, they have the element of a zoning team fight that they can bring here. But this is the one issue that they're going to have, is that they really don't come online until later in the game. Now, Veigar Brixton will have the ability to one-shot even at level 6, maybe. But again, you know, that's really only going to be super effective against his opposing number in terms of Nyx. And to be honest, Nyx likely won't be getting in range of Veigar, or at least that close to Veigar in a teamfight situation. So it's going to be about how they control vision, if they can make picks, and if they do come to a teamfight situation, landing the perfect zoning Cage into a Gnar ultimate, and then they could be able to run away with it.
One key concern I have for this Veigar pick as well is he picked it after we'd already seen that there was going to be a Sivir on the enemy team. So that kind of immediately eliminates one of your targets. So it's like, if Nyx isn't available as his target to kind of just all in and just blast away, he can't really then just turn onto the AD carry, because Spell Shield will just completely ruin his combo.
The one thing that Veigar is good, though, into Sivir is you know, Sivir classically is a group and win type scenario. You use it to make picks and then try and force a team fight. You just throw down that Cage, instantaneously you're going to have people trying to get around it. They can't walk through it. Not everyone has got a Sivir spell shield. So it's all very well if Sivir just runs through it, but if she's then isolated from the rest of her team who can't join her, it's going to be pretty difficult.
She does also have to walk through the other side as well.
Yeah, so
it's kind not of the greatest strategy.
Spell shield Cage herself in there might not be the best idea. I think that the Poppy pick was very clever into Veigar, because she will be the one that's getting into Veigar's face. And Veigar won't be able to burst her. Poppy is not burstable. Everyone knows that. As long as she gets some resistances behind her, she's very difficult to take down. So
I was going to say, this all depends if you're using my full AD Poppy build.
Full AD Poppy, maybe not.
Wouldn't recommend.
And then obviously, if you look at the other team, I think it was Poppy, Lee Sin, Syndra, Sivir, Braum. Now,
well remembered.
Yeah, I tried. They've got a really good split push, but then obviously Poppy will eventually struggle against Gnar, especially if that frozen mallet comes down for Gnar, which I think will be the most sensible first item choice for Gnar in this kind of scenario. You can really shut down Poppy's ability to duel you. She will get nowhere near to you unless receiving help from Lee Sin. They also have this element of pick. You know, I actually think in terms of a traditional team fight, as long as they can get around that cage, they probably fare slightly better. You know, they have that movement speed, they can chase people down, they have Scatter the Weak, which can hit multiple targets now, and Poppy will always be soaking damage in the front lane while the rest of her team follow her up from behind that area, and she will be soaking up Veigar, she'll be soaking up Ezreal, and in that team time her team can just mow through. But the longer they leave this, the more effective more effective Sensei are going to become with their composition. So, again, both compositions kind of doing a similar element. I do think that split push is slightly in favor of Sensei, especially post frozen mallet for the Gnar.
Yep.
But otherwise, both of them aiming to make picks. Both of them in some element aiming to control team fights. I feel like Veigar really shuts that Sivir ultimate down as long as the cage is saved. But if they do somehow manage to get around the cage, then Veigar becomes a very easy target.
Absolutely. Well, we'll see how this one is going to pan out. We should be able to jump onto the map shortly for you guys and actually be able to kick this first best of three off. I have just been informed that there's already a pause going on in the game. So, unfortunately, we won't be able to jump straight into the map. We will just waffle a little bit more for you guys. But, I mean, taking a look at these compositions, we've already talked about the top lane, we've talked about the bottom lane a little bit, as well as the mid. We haven't really touched on the jungle though. Elise versus Lee Sin. Like, how do you see this one panning out? Obviously, both of these junglers can be very proactive if they want to be.
Yeah, I'd say Elise has a slightly easier time making things happen in lane, just because she provides some hard CC to that particular element of gameplay, where Lee Sin really relies on just his pure damage output, so he has to be landing those skills. He either has to come from an area where he can get a flank off, has to be looking to do some, you know, do some sort of vision control in terms of getting around areas of vision the enemy team has. But the main thing that Lee Sin has over Elise is that he can be aggressive against her, as long as he's able to dodge that cocoon. That's the real key factor. If you get locked up by a cocoon in Lee Sin, she will beat most people in a one-on-one. But if Lee Sin can catch her unawares, be the one to be proactive and get the damage down, force her out of jungle, this is very easy for him to exploit. So we're back into game now.
Yeah, we are finally jumping onto the map here. It is going to be Sensei on our blue side up against Batman. He begins over on the red side of the map, and we'll see how this one is going to pan out. Now, we've already talked in depth about how we think Sensei, they're going to be the slight favourites coming into this one. Batmani obviously lost to them last week. Oh, no, they didn't. I'm telling complete porkies. But we'll see whether Batmani are going to be able to, with these new roster changes, come in swinging for this best of three. And, you know, there's going to be a lot to play for these guys. Brixton just getting a little bit harassed down and doesn't really achieve anything in terms of the actual game, but just asserting his dominance in the mid lane.
Yeah, that's exactly what the mid lane should be, though, Munchables. You know, asserting your dominance, putting your foot down. And actually, you know, Nick's, I think, level 1 to level 2, before that cage comes down, I think, you know, there is an element here where Nyx can be aggressive. You know, most people say Syndra's level 1 is the best level 1 in the game. Don't disagree with that. And I think this is a point where he wants to start punishing Brixton immediately. You can already see Brixton knows how this lane's going to go down. He's got the exhaust because he knows he's going to need it versus the ultimate of Syndra. Whereas Syndra's picked up the cleanse because she knows that the only thing that's going to be in an issue for her is going to be getting locked up by the CC from Veigar. So it's an interesting decision-making process in terms of those summoners, but I think both of them made the correct choice. I mean, Brixton could have considered the cleanse himself just specifically for Scatter the Weak, but I do think Exhaust in general is better here.
Yeah, I would agree with that one. And as well, Exhaust, it's not just about that one matchup. It's also about how effective it is moving forward in the game. Exhaust is always going to be a big factor in those team fights, especially if you can shut down something like the Syndra or even just an AD carry. But look at the damage coming out right now. Grissom actually in trouble. He's going to get stunned up. Exhaust already down in the bottom lane, but here we go. Grissom being forced away. The Ignite was used by Synergy as well, but Grissom did survive. The stun doesn't quite land. That's a flash for First Blood coming out from Monk. And well, they've made it happen for themselves. It cost them 3 summoners, but they traded it for 4 and a kill.
Wow, that's, like I said, the only way Bard gets punished in this lane is he gets locked up by a Winter's Bite and then gets stunned. Over-aggressive from Grissom. And wow, Monk and Synergy already showing that Batmani Begins means business here in this best of three.
They absolutely do, and we'll see if they can actually keep that up, because that is a fantastic start for them. They've got themselves the lead, and against an Ezreal as well, if you can get ahead of him and just force him under tower, force him to just be constantly clearing those waves, he will run out of mana very, very quickly and start to struggle. Jungle Trix, though, in the mid lane here, I don't think they're going to be able to finish off Brixton. Monk is in trouble. Grissom actually incredibly low and will go down as well, but he's traded 1-4-1. Synergy now in trouble himself, and Tyrant will be able to finish this kill off. One more auto is all that he needs. And there we have it, Batmani. They're going to be evened up right now as Sensei managed to trade 2-for-2 all in all now.
That was a really good gank by Tyrant, specifically because he saw that both Monk and Synergy were not content leaving the lane in that position. They wanted to push it up following what was a really good set of early trades for them. But because it was level 1, the respawn timers were low for Grissom, so he manages to come back into lane and combine very well with Tyrant. And actually, you know, Monk and Synergy, they were only level 1 and 2 themselves. Although Sivir's wave clear is some of the best in the game, her ability to push waves is fantastic. At level 1, it's not going to clear waves with just one ricochet. You need to have a little bit more in the tank for that. So very, very good presence of mind by Tyrant to head straight down there.
Yeah, absolutely. And he is duly rewarded. In the meantime, we do have Jungle Trick starting to hover towards his bottom lane. He's going to pick up that Scuttle Crab. And then he's going to just leave that fort now. But up in the top lane, as well as in that bottom lane, we're starting to see some significant CS leads build up for the side of Sensei. Both Inax and Averil starting to take the lead.
That was what I was expecting, though. Averil, in general, is going to do better against Poppy, especially post-Frozen Mallet as well. Poppy just is not going to have a good time against the Gnar in lane. Gnar generally is just so oppressive against everybody that has, you know, a melee main form, and that's exactly what he's good at, especially the percentage health-based damage. That's pretty solid against Poppy, too. So looks like Jungle Trix is looking to make an impact in the bot lane, but doesn't look like Sensei are going to fall for it. They're going to back off.
They certainly are. I think Inax is looking for an opportunity to go back to base at this point, maybe just after this wave, and maybe pick up an early tier, as he's got himself a kill and an assist, as well as those 30 CS. But Brixton is going to get stunned here. Sonic Wave does land, but I don't think they can continue this one. And Brixton will walk away with his life, but only just.
Only just. They couldn't commit to it, and I think Jungle Trix made a very good safeguard play there, because he knew that if he hadn't made that safeguard play, probably would have been locked up under tower. Synergy is now going to apply pressure here to Grissom, who will save his ward, but that is it.
Yeah, we'll be able to. Or Synergy will be able to keep that ward alive in the enemy jungle. It means that Grissom has to retreat back to his bottom lane once again. Here comes Tyrant, though, in the top lane. We could be seeing a dive, potentially. Looks like Tyrant decides to back away. He did get spotted out by a ward thrown down by level 99 Yordle. That is going to be good news for the Poppy in the top lane, because getting dived this early on, not a situation you want to happen.
Yeah, the issue is that when the vision comes down, you then as Tyrant don't know where the enemy jungler is. You don't know if the mid lane is rolling up from base. It's a very difficult and risky endeavor to take on in that situation. It's only good if you know that you're going to be a complete surprise. So I made the sensible decision to back off, even though we knew there was not going to be any support for like 99 Yordle. From Tyrant's perspective, he had no idea whether there would be or not, and it would have been very risky to try and make that kind of move. Sivir doing a great job of just blocking that that Bard stun.
Yeah, and Synergy as well just jumps on in front of Monk to block all of the damage incoming from Inax. But generally speaking, it was a pretty even trade, all things considered. And now we look up toward this top lane as Averil just consistently shoving Yordle underneath the tower and really making him struggle. But here comes Tyrant in the bottom lane, misses his stun though, and that is going to be the end of that gank.
Look at the vision control. Is this something I praised Sensei for against XL? Tyrant has got excellent vision control. Look at it, covering that red side jungle of Jungle Trix, really just mapping out his movements. You can see he's had very little impact in the lanes right now because, to be honest, everywhere has been so closely guarded and mapped by Tyrant. He has looked so good so far, and he's continuing that trend they had against XL in terms of superior vision control.
Absolutely. Well, 2v2 in the bottom lane. Grissom does manage to get through his magical journey. and will be able to survive with his life, but only just. In the meantime, Jungle Trix is going to clear away any vision they have around this bottom lane and maybe look for a lucky Sonic Wave, but Grissom, I don't think, is going to be silly enough to stick around in range.
Yeah, they're not getting much from this pressure, but they are remaining 200 gold ahead right now. So bot lane really coming into its own from Batmani Begins here. The mid lane going slightly in favor of Nyx in terms of CS, which is kind of what you'd probably expect against a Veigar early on here. And that top lane thoroughly now in favor of Sensei. Just massive of a difference in terms of CS. And this is kind of what you expect in this matchup as a Poppy. There isn't really a point in which you win hard against the Gnar, and especially if he does choose to go down Frozen Mallet path. Level 99 Yordle is going to be consistently under pressure. Look at Grissom here. Jungle Trix has made a roam round.
Allowing the red buff to go to Avril as well.
That's crazy.
That's going to make level 99 Yordle's life just miserable over the next few minutes. Jungle Trix, in the meantime, has stolen away the Sensei red buff, so it's just going to be traded one for one, but Brixton, I think he's going to be in trouble here. Jungle Trix is looking for an opportunity to get underneath this tower and take out that evil little Yordle. Brixton, if he does get stunned, he might just be going down. Has exhaust and flash available, so in theory, shouldn't get caught out by this, but here's the stun. They're going to go for it. The fight is going on elsewhere, but it doesn't matter because Nyx just deletes Brixton off the map.
One versus one. Nyx takes the kill there. Brixton not in range of exhaust. That's one thing that we didn't really bring into consideration here. Against the Syndra, max range ult, you're not going to be in range of landing the exhaust. Brixton knew that he had to run towards Syndra because otherwise there was no way he hits that exhaust, but unfortunately wasn't quick enough. Level 99 Yordle now. Having to put a pressure. That's really good pressure here.
He's going for it onto Avril, who will actually tank a tower shot as well, having to use that Gnar ultimate just to survive. And I don't think Yordle's done just yet. Avril has to use that flash in the end just to survive that situation. And really, really nicely done by Yordle. I didn't even start play-by-playing for a while because I didn't think anything was going to happen. But Yordle really making it work.
Yeah, he really put on the pressure there. Again, maybe a little bit overconfidence coming out from Avril here. Double stun lands onto Monk and Synergy, but nothing will come of it. Like you said, the Cull coming out on Inax, he knows he's in it for the long game here. Got that Sheen first, so we'll be looking to trade, I guess, just with those, there you go, the Arcane Shots, but that's not Arcane Shot, for some reason, Mystic Shot. Looks like Brixton's taking a bit of damage or with a little bit of pressure from Cull.
Oh, nice event horizon does come down. That's going to mean that trade is just about even between Brixton and Nyx. And let's bear in mind as well, the Primordial Burst will be available for Brixton. So if he can get close to the enemy mid laner, he will be able to one-shot just about as strong.
Nyx.
There's an exhaust. Nyx is in trouble. Brixton, I don't think he's even going to get a chance to get in on this fight because Inax is going to snipe out Nyx from the bottom lane all the way from downtown, picks up the kill.
Oh, poor timing right there for Nyx. He had absolutely no idea that roam was happening. Even though there's moderately good vision control, I actually don't know how he managed to sneak by there because he's got both vision.
I think they walked past those wards.
Yeah, they must have walked past those wards. He must have just not seen or not been told that he'd walked past that pink ward in the bot lane, unless that has just gone down by Braum recently. Otherwise, I'm trying to figure out how exactly Nyx was caught out by surprise there, but he was. And that's the kind of the major story. He was caught out by a double roam coming out from Grissom and Tyrion.
Yep. And that is going to... Oh, they did... Apparently they did a barred magical journey around the ward. Oh, so maybe over the wall of the raptors? It's got to have been maybe...
Yeah,
I'm not sure.
Potentially, yeah.
Either, no, because they came through the river.
Unless they
I'm
went,
not sure how they managed to get past that.
They either went over the dragon pit wall or through Tribrush into Dragon Pit. Yeah, they went over. Must have gone over Dragon Pit Wall through Tribrush and then just walked
Braum
up.
Braum must have put down the River Ward. Either way, let's move on.
That River Ward wasn't there when they made the gank. Braum put that down afterwards.
Yeah, okay. It all makes sense to me now, but here we go. Monk arriving on the scene. They're going to fight for this ward. Synergy blocking a lot of damage and will get a knock-up onto Grissom, who gets just about deleted. Jungle Trix is under the tower, though. A nice kick onto Tyrant to keep himself alive, and Tyrant will get finished off by Nyx as well. Fantastic bit of teamwork coming out from Batmani, and they will be able to walk away with their lives.
What a great dive coming up from Batmani. I've got to give it to Jungle Trix there. He looked fantastic in that particular engage. Level 99 Yordle also managed to stop the teleport of Avril, which is pretty key, but did pay for a lot of pressure in lane with it. has got teleport, so you can back off and teleport straight back to lane, but it doesn't look like Brixton wants to let that happen. Neither does Averill.
No, the slow is going to go down, and Yordle could be in trouble here. If another boomerang lands, it will, and there's a primordial burst coming out from Brixton. He's decided he's fed up of being irrelevant in this game, picks himself up a kill and a little bit of gold.
Look at the rotation coming out from Jungle Tricks and Nyx, though, straight onto that mid lane turret. Bard having to use it, but he gets spell shielded.
Oh, look at the damage coming out from Inax. He's going to keep his tower alive as well. Fantastic stuff. Monk nearly dies as well. True Shot Barrage will be on cooldown, so they can't finish anything off just yet, but the top lane tower will be finished off. It's traded for a mid lane. But importantly, Monk couldn't quite grab the tower gold for that bottom lane tier 1.
Probably even more importantly as well, first turret goes in favor of Batman. He begins by a matter of milliseconds.
Yeah.
They took that mid lane turret just ever so slightly before that top lane turret went down to Averill and Brixton. Interestingly, Munchables, Black Cleaver, the item of choice here for Averill. So instead of wanting to play these elongated fights with the Poppy, going straight for that heavy, aggressive armor shredding item in the form of Black Cleaver.
He's looking to go toe-to-toe in this matchup. Toe-to-toe.
Toe-to-toe.
You heard it here first, folks. But yeah, he's not wanting to rest on his laurels and kind of just kite at this point. He wants to go aggressive. And I like this from Grissom, pulling the minions away so that the tower doesn't get finished off by them. And here comes the AD carry off Inax just to finish them off as well. I actually want to see how much HP that tower is on. It's got to be like 5, if that.
It's got to be, yeah, literally in the single digits. I want to just raise a point about this build path from Averill, because he already has that rage advantage. He's already relying on the slow from the boomerang toss to be his main form of kiting against this Poppy. Maybe he just wants that armor shred. Maybe he just wants to be a little bit more aggressive in this particular scenario and doesn't feel like he needs Frozen Mallet to make that kind of thing happen. Look at the vision control from Sensei again. It results in that red buff being targeted once more by Averill, and with that Black Cleaver, going to go down very quickly here.
Yeah, absolutely. We'll be able to finish that one off. Level 99 Yordle. He wants to fight again, though, and Averill could be in trouble, especially since Nyx is on his way. Yordle still layering on this pressure, and Averill just begging for mini Narta proc once again, so he's got a little bit better kiting. Brixton arrives at the Event Horizon to get his Yordle friend to safety, but Jungle Tricks is here as well. They're looking to start a fight. Look at the mechanics coming out, but he doesn't actually find anyone. It looked flashy, but it didn't achieve anything in the end. Grissom is going to be the only one that goes down.
Yeah, and he kind of overstayed there, relying on that magical journey, but it was outplayed very nicely by Nyx, who managed to land Scatter the Weak and combo that into Winter's Bite to get the stun and the kill there. Very impressed by Batman He Begins so far, and they weren't wrong when they were saying they've improved on their scrim results and improved their gameplay. They're really pushing Sensei to the limits. I would even hazard to say are looking stronger than them at this point in time.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with you on that one. Right now, Batman He, they are showing us up. They are showing our prediction up at this point, and they're doing a phenomenal job. And if the rest of the series looks like this first 15 minutes has, we could well see Batman He moving forward into the next game of the day as well. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. It's a 3,000 gold lead in favor of Batman He. And they're going to be able to grab themselves a Cloud Drake as well. Jungle Trick's happy to pick that one up on his own here. But Sensei certainly not out of the game just yet. We've still got a long way to go between these teams.
Yeah, like I said, Sensei, realistically, in the later game, are going to have a very strong team fight. Their ability to burst people out with Brixton on Veigar and Inax's late game prowess on this Ezreal will all be very, very strong. I also want to just highlight the interesting build path that Brixton has gone down. He's prioritized a Spectre's Cowl here, but with that turret having gone down, he's unlikely to have to face Nyx on a one-on-one scenario that often from this point in time. So almost feels like that was an item that could have been saved for later. I guess he
picked up the Spectre's Cowl as his first item.
But that was in the laning phase. I guess he just wasn't expecting his tower to go down that quickly, but it just means his damage output is going to be slightly gimped. Now, it is Veigar, so we know that, you know, you can have a damage output regardless of what items you build. You get that AP through farming and through your Q.
And through your opponent's AP.
Yeah, exactly. Your ultimate is also always based on your opponent's AP in terms of damage. But it just does feel like he may be slightly lower damage output than he potentially would have wanted to be at this point in time.
Yeah, I think that is safe to say on this one. And has got that lost chapter now as well for the mana regeneration. Jungle Tricks hanging around fairly deep in the opponent's jungle right now. We'll get a pink ward down and clear some vision. but I wouldn't expect that pink ward to last all too long if the likes of Sensei are aware of the situation. In the meantime, down in the bottom lane, we've got the split push beginning. Once again, the top lane towers are gone, and so Averill's head down there to try and push onto that tier one of Batmany.
Yeah, and that's... well, I mean, that's what they have to start doing. They need to either force some pressure onto Batmany's tier one in the bot lane or try and get that tier one in the mid lane, because right now you're seeing all of the vision has had to become defensive. And what I've always praised Sensei for is their ability to make good, aggressive vision control work for them. They did it very well against XL. But they've had to go into a full defensive mode here. And I'm thoroughly impressed once more with their vision control. But it's just, it almost kind of... It pulls them back into having to make plays within their own jungle, which may not be as easy than being aggressive in the enemy jungle would have been with that tier 1 in the mid lane being down.
Yeah, well, I mean, I think we just saw a key example of how much the lack of AP is going to be affecting Brixton in this game. He's actually finished a Banshee's Veil at this point. Monk takes a huge amount of damage there, actually forced to use his heal.
That's crazy,
as well as
that he's
spell
gone,
shield.
Crazy that he's gone for Banshee's Veil, but it does make sense in a lot of scenarios. Whoa!
Oh, Nyx is in trouble. He does manage to flash away to safety, but the rappel comes on through. Tyrant finishes him off, and now Synergy has to flash away from the cage. Christen in a 1v2, but the rest of his team is about to arrive. He does go down, so no magical journeys for him today. Brixton, though, is maybe pushed a little bit too far. We'll be able to get away, though.
Yeah, that was a slightly mistimed ultimate from Synergy. I don't know if it would have saved the day onto Nyx regardless, but that was just an aggressive, classic Tyrant play there, just immediately saying, I'm going to make this happen. He did it against XL on Gragas all the time. Doing it again now against Batmany Begins, being the one to say, nope, let's flash in. If we get a pick here, fine, it's one kill. Maybe we can do something with it. They actually end up trading one for one, but this is looking so even between Batmany Begins and Sensei right now.
It certainly is. Synergy getting away with that recall. Nobody knew he was there, so nobody able to capitalize. Averill goes into Mini Gnar, and that is the green light for level 99 Yordle. He wants this fight and will be able to find it. He's going to get kited pretty heavily, though, here, as Averill just doing his very best, getting those slows down, will survive this engage, and he's still maintaining the CS lead as well. Oh, in the meantime, though, he's actually baited Yordle. But the ultimate will not land, neither will the cocoon. Yordle walks away.
Absolutely. Here come the trio of mid lane pressure that we've seen happen here for Batmany Begins. And I am honest with you, Munch, I've been thoroughly impressed. I was not expecting this level of play from Batmany. It looks like the addition of Monk, and especially you could see it in that bot lane as well. I mean, it's a 50 CS advantage to Monk as well, just so we haven't highlighted that yet, I don't think. But you could see it in their play in the early game. I mean, Synergy looked fantastic. Their two-on-two looked amazing. And through this vision control that they've managed to garner around this Baron area, because of how aggressive they managed to be with their vision, they're going to go for Baron. And I don't even know if Sensei can contest or even know it's happening.
Yeah,
I mean,
Sensei aren't even aware of this situation right now. They're pinging danger pings around their own brushes, but haven't even dared to look. There comes the True Shot Barrage. I think they realized at the last second, but it was too little too late.
Someone has come on to Batmany Begins and have just become a voice for their shot calling. And they look so much more decisive, so more well-rounded in a lot of scenarios than they have done previously. And honestly, Sensei, they're looking strong. I actually think they're almost looking as strong as they did last week, but it just looks like Batmany have stepped up.
Yeah, absolutely. Batmany, we're seeing a completely different team here to what we saw in the previous week of the Premiership. And right now, in this game, they're looking like absolute favorites with a 5,000 gold lead for themselves to work with. They're really starting to snowball this one. Look at the AD carries. 2,500 gold in favor of Monk over his lane opponent. That is a ridiculous lead to be boasting. And as well, similar kind of leads up in that mid lane. And when there's both carries starting to build such a tremendous gold lead, it starts to look really scary for the likes of Sensei.
Especially since Brixton's still only sitting on a defensive item and no tier 3 completed AP items at this point in time. It's not looking solid for his damage output. You know, especially going into an Abyssal Scepter on Nyx, who will have some of that magic resist built up, he might not even be able to one-shot people at this point. Nyx has gone down at a very low AP build path that will still make him effective. That's a very sensible build against Veigar. You kind of reduce his efficacy without his need to build any AP items. I like that coming out from Nyx. Yeah. Also want to point out that a four-item Sivir is also almost one of the scariest carries in the game. And once we get towards that point, they're trying to go for it here, but Nyx gets caught out.
Nyx has been caught and then just gets deleted. Sensei, well, they clearly have their teamwork in check right there. All of them working perfectly in tandem and just delete the enemy mid laner. And I like just how tight the ultimates all came out together. It was just like, in 1 second flat, he's just off the map.
Well, that's exactly what the composition from Batman Begins is built to do. You pick someone off. It's just chain CC, lots of burst, and they managed to get it to happen here in an area that I think Batman Begins felt pretty safe in, but obviously you just need to look at how Sensei control their vision. They have got very good scope of most of their jungle now, and I honestly feel like I talk about this all the time, but I cannot praise them enough for how good they've been in terms of vision control. Even when they're on the back foot, they consistently keep their vision alive, and it's all really driven by Tyrion, I would say, but are being kept up in terms of Grissom's building of the Ruby Sightstone, which has become pretty standard, by the way, for most supports. Jungle tricks going in, though.
Yeah, looking for the kick onto Grissom there as well. You saw that mini ward hop, but Grissom does manage to get his magical journey to safety. So no pick coming out from Batmani. They committed four people to the top lane in the meantime, but nice reactions from Sensei. They've kind of mirrored the situation at this point. Grissom will be able to pull himself to safety. Inax actually gets stunned up and will just get absolutely obliterated. Nyx more than able to one-shot an AD carry at this point with the amount of AP he's locked up for himself.
Grissom.
Grissom fails the flash and will get punished for it. There's a kill for Monk. This is starting to fall apart from Sensei. One of the things I was going to start to talk about was they haven't lost any inhibitor towers yet, but that story might change shortly.
Yeah, Baron is going to start wearing off soon, and I think it looks like they're trying to make the maximum use out of it. They know that it's going to be hard to seize the inhibitor tower, so they're going to go straight for what they can take, which will be this tier 2 in the top lane. Sensible decision-making coming out from Batman Begins. You know, they realize that it'll be a tough job for them to make use of that Baron that's just worn out now on an inhibitor turret. So at least they get some kind of presence out of it for just that particular top lane turret. Also, nice warding, by the way. Very unique and interesting warding points coming out from Sensei, because they realize that the pink vision is starting to creep into their jungle. They're putting them in places where they maintain an element of vision control, but are trying to evade the grasps of those pink wards. And you can see here, clearing comes through, and once again, they're going to start to regain control of their jungle.
Yeah, I've got to say props to Brixton on this one, on how well he's been farming this game comparatively to, you know, how much pressure he's been under in this mid lane.
Oh, absolutely.
We saw many, many ganks go his way, and he's on 210 CS, basically even with Nyx. But the crucial thing about that is Veigar doesn't just get the gold from his CS, he also gets that AP, every single one that he manages to get the last hit with his Q. So he will be snowballing kind of just by farming a lot harder than other champions would be. And now he's finished his Morella Nomicon, we're going to start to see Brixton actually enter the game.
I'm actually really looking forward to Brixton starting to come online here, because I like I said, he hasn't died except for that one-on-one against Nyx. He's been very safe otherwise. The Banshee's Veil's paid off for him in terms of safety too. He's still been doing a decent amount of damage, although maybe not as much as he would have wanted to. And you're right, his farm has been fantastic, given how far the rest of his team have looked, especially in the bottom lane, which is about 4 or 5 CS away from a Flame Horizon here. It's looking pretty... I'm thoroughly impressed with Brixton, but I like the strategy coming out from Batman Begins here. Yordle and Jungle Tricks looking to make the split push happen.
Yeah, but will get denied in the end. Yordle actually taking a lot of damage, and Avril, I'm not sure if he's done at this point. Needs to be careful, though. I'm not sure you can 2v1, my friend. With 3v3 in the bottom lane.
That's the Frozen Mallet coming out against the Poppy. She just can't do anything against it. You know, Poppy has one mode against Gnar. All in engage and try and make something happen and force him out, or literally just get kited to oblivion. And you can see with the Frozen Mallet, that limits the opportunities even further. Batman Begins aren't going to risk anything in this situation. They're going to back off straight away.
Yeah, and it feels like for a second here, Sensei have a bit of a breather. There's no Baron available for Batman. Everything's going to be spawning in a minute's time. And Batman definitely don't want to be caught in a siege when everything respawns. They want to be ready to just jump on and grab those objectives immediately. And importantly, they need to have vision control of this Baron area. So they back away. They realize no more sieging can be done right now, and they need to regroup and prepare for these neutral objectives.
Yeah, I realize we made a nice Twitter follower has highlighted a mistake for us. We were talking about the old Veigar, no longer scales off enemy AP anymore.
Oh, really? I didn't even know that.
Genuinely, I haven't seen Veigar in a professional match for such a long time. Completely forgot.
We're wrecked. Well, either way, it looks like the fight for Baron Vision will continue. And it's Batmani that are winning so far. Jungle Trix is going to be locked up, though, in a cage right now. There's a nice ultimate, though. Tempered Fate locks everyone up and actually denies some of the damage out of Inax. Yordle onto this backline right now. He's 1v3, but he's surviving. This kite will come through, and Jungle Trix will pick up Tyrant. In the end, Nyx will get finished off as well, though. So it's a mid laner for a jungler.
It's a good trade, but Monk, you can see him starting to turn on with this three-item Sivir, really starting to do some serious damage. Good pressure being put down by Brixton. It does mean that most of Batmani Begins are going to have to back off here. I don't think they're going to be able to safely take Baron. And they will just start to filter away. Monk playing a dangerous game here versus Grissom and Inax. He will also back off at the end.
He certainly will. Well, it's going to be an interesting fight, to be quite honest, because that wasn't as one-sided as you would have expected in favor of Batmani. You would think that Sensei should be losing that fight a little bit more convincingly.
So, Primordial Burst now deals damage based on the target's missing health as opposed to target's AP.
Ah.
So actually, it's good against pretty much everybody.
Nice.
So, he'll have a good time against pretty much anybody on the side. I would argue that's better as well. That kind of makes Veigar more versatile as a burst-based.
When did they change that?
That must have been through his rework. You know, he had a slight rework, like a mini rework.
I don't specifically remember that change. Either way, it must have been a while ago, but like you said, I don't think I've seen Veigar in basically since the day of his rework, so never mind. But although there was that short stint of Veigar support that came out very briefly.
Did we ever
briefly.
See that in the UK scene? I don't think we ever saw anyone pick that up in UK scene.
Not sure. Either way, let's get back onto this game. It's 7-11 right now, and I'm not talking about your day job. And the gold lead, 8,000 in favor of Batmani. Nice little stun comes out from Nyx, but it's onto Avaril, that Meganar, or he's about to be at least. So not the greatest of targets, and it means that they do just have to back away once again. But Brixton, aggressive position here. Monk will get spotted out right now, and if they can land the stun, actually using the Event Horizon onto Yordle instead. They're going for the Poppy, but he's so tanky. That can't be the target that you start the fight on. And Synergy now, tankied so much damage, gets the knockup onto Avril. Jungle Trix on this backside. They're looking for
kick.
Kick onto a couple, but it doesn't finish off anyone except for Grissom, who does go down. Monk pushing aggressively. He is on the hunt right now. Already used his flash, though, and Avril will survive. Brixton super low, will get dived here by Yordle, but doesn't quite get finished off, and it's down to Inax now. He's got to be the god that he claims to be if he wants to win the fight.
Monk on Sivir is almost untouchable, especially with QSS. He is just chunking through Sensei right now. I think the main things to take away here, they're actually going to go for Baron as well, but this is exactly what we talked about Poppy doing for his team. He just soaked up all of that burst damage directly for Batmani Begins there. Everything that was useful was burnt onto Yordle, and they're going to get Baron Nashor once more. This is a super strong gameplay from Batmani Begins. They have looked fantastic.
Yeah, and I've got to say, I feel like that was a major risk, really, from the likes of Sensei to just start the fight on Yordle. You know how tanky he is. Look how much resistance he has. He has two MR items and two armor items, as well as an absolute shedload of HP. He is not going to struggle to survive your entire team's burst. And then the second you've done that, what do you have remaining for the rest of the team fight?
Absolutely. Looks like Nyx has gone for the Void Staff as well, something that has been prioritized very early on for most mid lane, especially how easy it is to pick up some form of magic resistance. Also have to note that Avril hasn't picked up any form of magic resistance whatsoever. You saw him get chunked by Scatter the Weak very hard just before that previous engage broke out. So honestly, he really built for that ability to deal with Monk's damage and maybe for the 1v1 versus Yordle, but right now you have to worry about Nyx's damage output too. He's almost four item Syndra. That's incredibly scary. Synergy going to sit in the middle of the
Yeah, here we go. Synergy pushing forwards. Tempered Fate onto two members, but it's the jungle and the support, so it doesn't really stop the siege at this point. Monk already had to use his QSS, so if he does get CC'd, he's in a whole heap of trouble. But here we go. Jungle Tricks going very deep for this one. Gets stunned underneath the tower and will be able to flash out to safety. I can't believe he survived that one. Yordle, happy to push on forwards, takes out the tower, and now they're onto the inhibitor. Nick flashes forward and gets the kill onto Inax. This will be the inhibitor, and with the Baron minions on top of everything, they might be able to push for more. In fact, I think they're going to change lanes.
They're going to change lanes, my friend. I'll tell you what Ezreal does not like, and that's six balls to the face. And he took six solid, magical balls to the face right there from Syndra, and he did manage to get blown up. Very, very good flash play coming out from Nyx. And Inax had got no heal on cooldown. He hasn't prioritized any magic resist himself. Hasn't picked up a QSS, for instance, because he doesn't really feel like he needs to at this point in time. And, wow. Damage output from Syndra. Who knew? Pretty good.
I think everyone knew, is the answer to that question. Yeah, Nyx is... he's definitely come online, I think it's safe to say. But realistically, Nyx has been ahead for this entire game.
And look at Monk, by the way.
His damage has just been terrifying.
Monk, like...
515, 150 CS ahead of his opponent, 7,000 gold ahead individually. Monk is terrifying right now.
He's half of the gold lead that Batman Begins have right now.
Just, I mean, we already saw how much damage he can do when he's pushing forward in these fights. When On the Hunt is proc'd, he can just destroy health bars. And with how tanky Yordle is as well, he can just sit behind the rest of his team.
Look at Ricochet. Look at Ricochet's damage. 664 crits across everybody sat on that right side of the defense for Sensei. That was just mega damage coming out from Monk. He is a monster. This is what a four-item Sivir can do, Munchables. It is one of the scariest AD carries to face up in the game. They're going to go straight for the siege here.
Yeah, they managed to take the tower, and Grissom once again going to be the target. Brixton locked up against the wall by Yordle and will be in trouble. Nice knock-up. There goes Inax, actually pushed away from this one. Jungle Trick's not going to chase in those sticks with his team. It's one for one so far. Both mid laners have gone down, but it's going to be Averil as well that drops, and in the meantime, Jungle Tricks has gone super deep and will be able to walk away with his life. He is tanky enough to walk away from these situations, and you can see that Jungle Tricks has quite clearly played a huge amount of Lee Sin in his lifetime.
2-0-7, escaping with a sliver of health each time. Another inhibitor goes down here for Sensei, and they're going to have to duel against two lanes of super wave minions. We also haven't touched on the dragons. It was something that I was going to pick up earlier, but there is three Cloud Drakes picked up right now and one Ocean Drake. So three Cloud Drakes, combine that with the Sivir movement speed as well, makes their engage potential huge, their ability to cross that map mega. Very, very good play, and it just looks like an Infernal Drake has spawned. So it'll be the icing on the cake in terms of Drake taking right now. And it's just before the Elder Dragon is due to come online as well, so they'll get that one very quickly.
You could say it's the icing on the Drake.
Icing
really
on the Drake.
To, but
yeah, I missed that one.
This is going to be an Infernal Drake taken in favor of Batmany. And well, like you rightly describe it, the icing on the cake, it's not something that they need at this point. They are so far ahead, both top and bottom lane inhibitors down, and now they're going to start to push towards this mid lane as well. Just waiting for everyone to head back to base, grab some final items, and then push straight on back. I can just point out as well that we're 35 minutes into the game, and Monk has finished his item build at this stage. He's completed. He's completed League of Legends.
He's completed
the
game
first player
of
ever
League of Legends.
To complete the game.
And he's got a very threatening build path as well. He'll be able to chunk through that armor that Averil has built up. And there isn't really anyone else that's picked up much armor apart from Ezreal here. So that'll be very effective against dealing with that frontline Gnar. But he'll be burning through everyone else regardless. And they're going to go for this final siege of the game with those super minions pushing in. They just need to take their time.
Yeah.
And you can imagine they'll be having a very, very... I mean, look how much damage that Monk does to the tower right there.
Oh my god, Averil solo. Nyx actually does get chunked out. Inax trying to get that damage down. Monk on the right-hand side, though. He's looking for an opportunity.
What?
He finds it. Three auto-attacks is more than enough. And down goes Inax. Grissom trying to get a magical journey, but it's not going to be far enough. Averil will just about escape with his life, but Grissom will not be so lucky. This is going to be the wipe going in favor of Batmany Begins, and can you believe it? Batmany, after all we were saying before this game about how Sensei, were the heavy favourites that Batmani, we weren't sure if these subs would be enough. They definitely are enough. And Batmani convincingly in the end take this first map.
Gotta say, Monk and Jungle Tricks have been an excellent addition to this lineup. Synergy and Monk looked fantastic in that bot lane. They really did.
I think that level